Today, our main talk, because this I explained before, is, subhanAllah, something that many of us do not know. What does التحيات mean? When we, myself and you, learned how to pray, we were just taught this is the position where you say the تحيات. I don't remember anyone teaching me what does the تحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات. All we do is just we repeat. We have no clue. And that's one of the reasons that we are not having khushu' in our salat. Because we are just repeating words that we have no clue what they are. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, we used to say in the salat, As-salamu ala Allah min ibadih. We used to say, salam on Allah from his ibad. Rasulullah s.a.w. heard him and he told him, do not say this because Allah is As-Salam. Instead, say, and then he taught them and the whole ummah till the day of judgment, say, التحيات لله والصلاوات والطيبات السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. What does it mean? التحيات is plural of تحية. تحية in Arabic means greeting. The ulama had a couple of meanings for التحيات. All the greatest of greetings belong only to Allah Azza wa Jal. Any greeting, any ta'zeem, any tawqeer, any taqdeer belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal, and that is all under at-tahiyyat. When I see my brother, when I end my message, I say tahiyyati lak, my tahiyyat, my greetings to you. But the minutes you add alif lam to the tahiyyat, that means it's only to Allah Azza wa Jal. I cannot say at-tahiyyat li Ahmad, at-tahiyyat li Mahmud. No, tahiyyati li Mahmud, yes. But at-tahiyyat, when I add alif lam, it only belongs to Allah. What is the verb from at-tahiyyat? You hear some people saying sometimes, greeting each other by saying hayyak Allah, right? Hayyak Allah. This is a good, excellent tahiyya. This means التحيات البقاء الدائم, the eternal life, and that only belongs to Allah when you add alif lam to it. Only one who will ever stay is Allah Azza wa Jal. الحي الذي لا يموت. التحيات لله. التحيات لله. Another opinion, it says that التحيات includes all the verbal عبادات. All the verbal عبادات belong to Allah Azza wa Jal. والصلاوات. الصلاوات is a plural of salat. Every salat I make, ya Allah, is only to you. The fard, the nafil, the sunnah, every salat I make belongs to you, ya Allah. والصلاوات. And they said here, الصلاوات, every physical عبادة is under the salawat. والطيبات. الطيبات, they said that this, all the verbal and the physical عبادات that are pure are belonging to Allah Azza wa Jal. At-tahiyyatu lillah. All the best of greetings belong to Allah. All the salawat that I make, I do not make it to anybody except to Allah Azza wa Jal. Wat-tayyibat, and some said this is the financial ibadat because Allah is tayyib and he only accepts what's tayyib. All the good, all the pure a'mal, all the pure words. Some ulama said at-tayyibat is subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. At-tahiyyatu lillah was-salawatu والطيبات. All of them belong to Allah Azza wa Jal. Then, السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته. We have been deprived in this dunya of greeting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam live. May Allah grant us this opportunity in the akhirah. So when you say it in the salat, wallahi it is disgraceful. التحيات لله والصلوات والطيبات السلام عليك يا نبي رحمه الله وبركاته. Would you dare say this kind of salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if he's standing in front of you? السلام عليك يا نبي رحمه الله وبركاته السلام علينا وعلى عباد. Would you dare say that? You are actually sending salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At this point specifically, your words traveling 8,000 miles to go to Medina. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every time you say salam to me, Allah will assign angels that will take this salam and present it to me. Do you think your salam that you are making in this salat worth being moved from here all the way to there? With that kind of salam, that speed in the salam that we make, you are making salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. What does this salam? I am making dua. I am making dua for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm making dua of salama to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm making dua of rahmah and barakah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Have respect when we are saying this dua. We rush and speed because we want the salat to be over. And that's why we are not finding any change in our life. Because Allah promised that the salat will prevent us from falling into sins and major sins. But I pray and I deal with riba. I pray and I do not wear the hijab. I pray and I sell alcohol. I pray and I drink and I pray and I gamble. Why? Because something's wrong with that salat. Something's wrong with the salat. It's not being given its proper rights. السلام عليك أيها النبي ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام علينا وعلى عباد الله الصالحين. Listen to what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said about this statement. السلام علينا. Usually, if I want to say salam to myself, I say السلام علي. Why am I saying it in plural? When I say salamu alayna in the salat, I am sending salam to everybody who's praying with me in that jama'ah. Assalamu alayna. And to who? And Rasulullah ﷺ said, every time you say assalamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi as-salihin, your salam will get to every righteous person in the earth and in the heavens. Your salam will get to every abd salih. Every righteous person on earth will get that salam. As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi as-salihin. And then we utter the shahada so many times per day to confirm that we are Muslims, to confirm that we are muwahideen. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. The word, the reason the creation was created because of La ilaha illallah. The Jannah was created because of La ilaha illallah. The Anbiya were sent because of La ilaha illallah. And I utter it every single day, many times, to confirm my shahada. That's one of the kids. When we have so many shahadas here, a kid, he came to me at 9 years old. He said, Sheikh, I don't remember taking my shahada. I said, ya Habibi, you take your shahada every single day so many times. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Please, my brothers and sisters, please, when we pray our next salat, the sunnah you're about to pray, when you get to the tahiyyat, please start pondering and thinking about what you're saying. You are greeting Allah, literally. You are greeting Allah, literally. You are sending salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember when I gave the whole workshop about improving our salat, I said one of the keys, one of the secret keys to enjoy the salat and to change it completely, drastically, is tell yourself, I am talking to Allah. I am talking to Allah. So when I am saying attahiyyatu lillah, I am greeting Allah Azza wa Jal, because the salat is a meeting between me and my creator. So let's have some adab. Let's have some adab when we are greeting Allah and when we are greeting our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.